Welcome to Raja Susila Holistics. Let's check the energies for Aryans this week. The first card we are taking to see how are your energies today. The first card for you, the Christ, open the door to the kingdom of heaven. Your doors for the kingdom of heaven to bring all good luck is opened this week. So be open to new changes coming in your life. Let's see what the energies are there for you, how it is, how you need to focus and channelize it. The first card for you is Divine Essence. This card says, examine who you truly are, allow you to be natural and joyful. You need to be natural and joyful and allow the energies of universe work upon you. The second card for you is Fun. Build leisure time into your life and look at your challenges from a higher perspective. Challenges are quite natural in life, but you need to see with higher perspective. Have some fun in life. Make some time for yourself. That is the advice given to you this week from the universe. And the third card for you is Pools of Energy. This card says it is time now to manifest your dreams and focus on your vision. Only negative things can hold you. So call on or visualize the violet flame. Now what this card says, the pool of energies is surrounding you. So it is up to you that whether you pick up the positive energy or you pick up the negative energy. The more you visualize the positive energy around you, the more you can manifest it. That is a message from the universe to you. Now let's see what the tarot has to say for you. The first card in tarot for you today is Temperance. Temperance says that energies are prevalent around you, both negative and positive, happiness and unhappiness. So you need to be balanced. Rather than putting your mind in negative things, you need to be balanced. The second card for you is Eight of Swords. It says some recent thing or setback has made you immobile, or it has made you that you can't do anything. You are stuck up. So this position is only for 1 week. So you have to overcome this feeling from you to be more positive. And the third card for you is Five of Wands. This card says that there is a lot of mental agitation around you, maybe some conflict with your people around you. That is also indicated. So you need to be calm. That's why the Temperance card has come. But this card, Five of Wands, is a card which indicates profit also with the conflict or the fight you are doing or the work you are doing. You will get profit. That is also ruled and not ruled out. Now let's see what the angels want to give the messages for you. Let your past go. The angels say that maybe there may be some past bitter incidents happened in your life that is pulling you back. So the angels urge you that you leave the past and move ahead so that your life will be pleasant and you can invite good things in life. And second thing is listen. All our questions in the universe is answered within you, but you need to get those answer only in your quietude. So find some time for yourself for meditation. You will get the answers within you. So listen to your inner self, what it wants to tell you. And the other card for is Daydream. So you got the other card also, the Divine Essence, Pool of Energy. Both say that Daydream, you need to manifest things with your energy, then only you can acquire good things. Manifesting good energy in your life is only through daydreaming. You have to dream, visualize what you really want rather than brooding upon what is happening around you. So daydream, think and manifest good things in your life. So these are the energies to you and advices to you. Hope you follow all these to bring new things in your life. If you like our channel, like, share and subscribe. Let's check the energies for Taurians this week. What is the advice, in which matter you need to focus? The first card for you is Wishes. Be careful what you wish for, as one wish will be granted. This week your wish will be granted, but be careful in choosing the wish. That is the message to you. Now let's see what the higher realms want to send message, in which matter you need to focus. The first card for you is contentment. Enhance your feeling of well-being and attract harmonious situations. You need to be content and give gratitude to the universe for what it has given you. The more you pay gratitude and you are content, you can attract good things in life. The second card for you is Black Mage. It says that the end of a cycle, situation and relationships can be better than the old. There is a shift of energy changes in your life. Some old thing has going to be ended and a new thing is going to start. But so vision for a good thing happening in your life. This is the second card for you. And the third card for you is water. So water, as you immerse yourself in the cosmic energy, sense it purifying. Use water for deep inner and outer cleansing. Water is the card, you have got it. So the message from the angels is try to spend more time in water and manifest your wishes through water manifestation. So that is the thing. So let's see what the tarot has for you this week. Tarot energies, what they say and how it will be for you. The first card for you is King of Pentacles. It says that you need to be with balance. Putting your mind, being analytical is more important for you than being emotional this week. That is very important. The second card for you is 10 of Wands. That says that there will be lot of responsibilities and you feeling the workload being more to you. So you may not be happy with it. The third card for you, the Sun. The Sun card says the future is bright and you can overcome the hardships you are undergoing right now. So let's see what the angels want to send you message. Change in direction. Again, the other card, like the first card, the Black Mage has told that there is some old thing is going to end and a new thing is going to come. Similarly, in this card, change in direction is indicated. Some change in direction and experiences and new experiences are going to come in your life. Something major is going to change in your life. And second card is go for it. Your prayers and positive expectations has been answered by the universe. So you will be getting something very great and new. But at that point of time, don't hesitate by thinking many times whether it is good or not. You go ahead with it. That is good for you. That is the message from the universe. So these are the energies for you this week. So go by it and introspect yourself. If you like our channel, like, share and subscribe. Let's check the energies this week for Geminis, what advisors and in which sphere you have to focus. The card is blessings. Count your blessings and the good in your life will multiply. You need to count the blessings and good energies you are surrounded with by the universe, so that the more you think about it and more you give thanks to it, it will be multiplied. That is the message for you. Let's see what the higher realms want to send you the message this week. The first card is gratitude again. The one I told you, sir, count your blessings and be gratitude to the universe, it will multiply. The same card has come again, gratitude. Pay gratitude to whoever has done good to you, to the Almighty and the universe. That pay gratitude every day, every now and then, so that you will get more and more out of it. The second card is 12 chakra. It says find time and space to become quiet and remember who you truly are. Relax and tune into your potential. The 12 chakras in your body is now activated by the universe. You need to concentrate on it and reap the benefits from it. So put some time in your own self meditating. That will help you to overcome many things in your life. The third card is Ice Age. This says the seeds of new beginnings are germinating. New things are started to germinate in your life. You need to activate it by meditation and praying gratitude to the universe. That is the thing here. Now let's see what the tarot has to say for you this week ahead, guys. So first card. So first card for you is two of swords that says opportunities will come, but you will be thinking whether to take it or not to take it. You will be in mental confliction about a certain thing, whether it is good or not. So need to change your thinking and be more analytical. And second card again is two of pentacles. Again this card says many ways, two ways. A major two ways will come in your way, so you will have tough time to take decisions. Maybe it is regarding your personal life or your career life. You will be more in confusion. The more you put confusion, the more the things will be complicated. So put your faith in the universe and take a bold decision. Five of Pentacles again says that in this situation, you will feel that you are left alone. You don't have anyone to share your problem. You will feel that nothing is happening. But again, I would say count down the blessings and pay gratitude to the universe so that you will get the right answers at the right time. And the angel's message is family. This situation is rooted in an emotional experience with a family member, which we can help you to understand. There may be some issues in your life regarding your family member, so that problem also can be rectified with your asking help from the angels to rectify your problem. The other card for you is child. You care deeply about children. Maybe that family person may be your child or your children on whom you are more giving thought and worried about. Need not worry. The blessings and the blessings from the universe is there. So count the blessings what you have got in your past and pay gratitude. That is the thing you have to focus to reap more in life. So things are changing. So concentrate on your 12 chakras to manifest good things in life. If you like our channel, like, share and subscribe. Let's just check the energies for Cancerians this week, in which matter you need to focus. The first card for you is magic. There is magic around you, so expect excitement and joy. Some great good news is going to come. Some magical things are going to happen. Something is manifesting in your life, so you need to be happy and invite it with both your hands. That is the message. Now let's see what the message from the higher realms you are getting. The first card for you is telepathy. Someone is trying to contact you through telepathy mode, so pay attention by finding some time, quietude and meditation. You will get who wants to contact with you. Maybe your friend or some angels want to contact with you. The other card is nature. The card says that spend some quality time in nature so that that quietude can be achieved and you can know who wants to contact you. And that may be a whisper from a fairy or a message from the angel for your highest good. And the third card for you is unicorn. So it is unicorns who want to contact you. They are the celestial beings who bless with unlimited grace and blessings. So meditate upon unicorns to give you good suggestions in which way, in which matter you want suggestions and blessings. So let's see what the tarot card has to say. The first card for you is four of pentacles. It says that you are in a satisfied position, but still there is something that you are not opening up. You need to be a little bit open and let things unfold on its own. So holding on for quite long time is not going to help you. The second card for is the fool. The time is very good for beginning something new in your life. Some new partners can come, new idea, new projects can come. If anyone is expecting for a new friendship, a new affair in your life, or a new spark in your love life, that can be possible in this time. And the third card for you is two of pentacles again. At this junction, you will again have some mental unclarity that you can do this or you can't do this. You will have this that dilemma. That's not good for you. Now let's see what the angels have to tell you. The first card for you is play, beloved one. It is time to set aside work for a while. They say that you need to find some time for yourself, for quietude to end. That is in nature. That's what this card also says, that take some time for yourself and play and have fun so that you can get the messages from the angels. The other third card is giving and receiving. The entire universe operates in cycles. The more you give, the more you get. So whoever wants love, care and attention of yours, give them more so that you get from the universe. So this is the message for you from the universe this week, guys. So I think you have got the point. If you like our channel, like, share and subscribe. The energies for Leos this week, how this week will be and in which field you need to focus, and what are the messages from the angelic realm. The first card for you is perspective. Examine your situation from a bigger and higher perspective. For you now, the what all is happening in your life, you may be thinking from your perspective, but it is better that you see from the higher perspective, that it is happening for your highest good, rather than brooding and thinking upon why, what happened, why it is all happening. Think about the from a higher perspective, that whatever happens happens with a purpose in life, that it is for your highest good. Let's see what the higher realm cards has to say for you. Enlightenment, this card says enlightenment is being in oneness. So forget about tomorrow, forget about the past, be in the present, connect with the higher one and be with the oneness of God. Be, get enlightened yourself. That will help you to overcome many of the problems. The more you get connected with the higher realms, the more you will get the oneness. And when you get the oneness, all your problems are in the hands of the Almighty. So you need not ponder about it. That is the first and the most important message you have got. The second card is technology. This card says do not be over reliant on technology. Use your time wisely and explore new possibilities. Don't put more time in technology and waste time seeing mobiles, TVs, watching laptops and all. Rather, connect yourself with the higher realms to get better messages. And third card for you is relaxation. You need to relax yourself and find some time for yourself. Relax yourself and connect with the higher realms. All the three cards are interrelated, telling you to relax and give your problems to the higher realms and connect with the Almighty and get the oneness of the God. The tarot card says 10 of Pentacles says that your attention fully will be on your home and your family members, and you can do well to them and they will get good attention from you and help from you, and you can make things better. And the second card for you is the Fool. The card says new beginning is going to happen in your life. It can be your career, your spirituality or your love life. Anything, something starting new will give you good returns. That's what this card says. The third card for you is the Hanged Man. The Hanged Man says, however, the future is good, the help from the higher realms are there, everything is good, but still you feel that the situation is not good, you are not happy. But again, some enlightenment is coming. This card is also a card of enlightenment, and the Hanged Man is also a card of enlightenment. Means that some message from the universe will come to you and you will be enlightened and your problems will be solved. But at present you are not happy, but you should find some time to quiet yourself, meditate and get the answers. The card for you from the angelic realms is innocence. It says enjoy the peace within your heart once more. So bring out the innocent you from you. The Fool card also represents innocence, innocent new beginning. And this card also says innocence. You need to bring the innocence from you rather than thinking with logical perspective. Bring the innocent you from your heart. That will solve most of your problems. Don't be too much analytical at this time. The other card is acceptance. Acceptance that the higher realms are working for you, not that you are the only one. You are the first card for you is examine yourself from the higher perspective. That's what the first card came to you. That this card says that accept the higher realms energy in your life and let the energy flow. Don't stand in between you and the highest realm. Let the flow go. That's what the today's message is for this week. If you like our channel, kindly like, share and subscribe. districts. Let's check the energies for Virgans this week. How, in which way you need to focus your life this week. The first card is moving. Change is happening. So be prepared to move physically or spiritually. Some major shuffle in energy is there. It may be spiritually or it may be physically. There is some moving is there. So you may move up to some place or some shift in your thought or your energies are there. So be prepared for the changes. Let's see what the higher realms want to tell you, in which way you need to focus this week. The first card for you is birth crystals. The birth crystal says deepen your roots to create a solid foundation, strengthen your connection with home and ancestral heritage, meet new people, deepening friendship. You need to deepen your root from the root where you have come, your old friends, your parents, your ancestors, your heritage people, or your childhood friends and all. You need to deepen your relationship with them. That will help you this week. The second card for you is the fifth dimension. If you drew this card, your guidance is to ask yourself how you would like to be treated and act upon. Act towards others as you would like to be treated. Treat others as you want to be treated. That is the essence of this card. So the fifth dimensional energies say that what you put, you will get. You do good, you be loving to others, you will get back what you have put. And the third card for you is creative expression. Whatever you need to expression, you express it in a unique way and express in a clear cut way so that people don't get any misconception upon you. So the more clarity you put in life, the more clarity you will get in your life. That's what this card says. So have unconditional love so that you get back the same type of treatment you get from others. That is the message. The tarot card says the star, the future is bright, things what you hope will happen, and all things will go, move on in a positive way. That's the card for you. The second card is Queen of Pentacles. That says that things will happen in your way, your planning will be good, and people will cooperate you. You will get the support from your family, friends, and all other places, and you can win over the situation in which you want victory. And the third card for you is Nine of Swords. Says, but you are somewhere backlogging with your fears and anxieties, so you're not able to move on. So you need to move on. That's what this card also says, that you need to move on, leaving all your fears. So the moving is necessary this week. Let's see what the angels have to say to you, what and how you need to prepare yourself. Shower of abundance. So it is to heal your financial situation, whether it is your financial situation or whatever situation, you give it to the universe, so they will shower you abundance. You need to give them your worries, and you give all the worries and accept good things from the angels by you. Positive thoughts in your life. The shower of abundance is there on you from the universe. The shower of abundance need not be only financial, in all other matters also. Joy is the highest energy. You attract and create your present and future movement at their highest possible levels. So you need to prepare yourself in a joyful mood. The more happy you are, the more happier you can get. Here also creative expression and fifth dimension says what you create, that you will get back. So you need to create a joyful situation to bring joy in your life. If you like our channel, kindly like, share and subscribe. Energies for Librans this week. How this week going to be? In which matter you need to focus? The first card for us is choices. There is another way. Ask your unicorn to help you find it. Maybe now the situation is as such that you want some way to get out of all the unhappiness in your life, and this card says choices are there. There is another way. There is another way of thinking, another way coming in your life. So concentrate on changing your pattern of thinking and ask the unicorn for help to bring changes in your life. Let's see what the higher realms has to say for you. Marriage is there in your card. Make a commitment. If your relationship needs commitment, make it as a marriage. If you are searching for some proposal, this time is good for something good happening and some talks of marriage happening in your life. And marriage is also a communion of two souls. That is also not ruled out. So communion of two souls from two different perspective is indicated. dedicated this week in High Priest. The High Priest card says, lead with strength and wisdom. At this time, you need to lead yourself with inner strength and wisdom. That is very important. Rather than being carried away by emotions, you need to be a little bit analytical in this time. The other card for you is silence. Make some time with silence and see what you really need and what you don't need and what situation is and how you can overcome it. It can be rectified with your quietude and silence. Your inner heart will give you the remedies. That's what this card says. Let's see what the tarot has to say. See what the tarot has to say for you. This week, the first card for you is Ace of Wands. Good news is coming, good things are coming, happiness is coming, some major shift of energy for highest good is indicated. The second card for you, the Hermit. The Hermit says, you need to find yourself some wisdom from your inner self. Try some solitude, some time for silence and get the answers within you. This card advocates the same thing. Bring the wisdom from your inner self, from the quietude of your heart. The third card for you is Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups is again is a card of manifesting, that you can manifest good things with care, nay, and others support. Things will happen in your favor. The only thing is that you have to be a little bit analytical and take wise decisions with your inner Rhea. From your inner self, you have to get that boldness and good thoughts. You have to inculcate in yourself. Let's see what the angels have to say. New partner, again, here you have got a marriage card and here you have got a new partner card. So it says that some new person will enter in your life and that will be a life partner to you, who will be, and you can enter a committed relationship with a choicest partner of your heart. The other card for you is relationship again. So this card says that your relationship, whatever you are having now, if you don't have, you will get now. If you have, it says that it will become a committed relationship. So enjoy, guys. You have got a very good card as far as your relationship is concerned, but you have to put some time in yourself to take better decisions and be a little bit analytical rather than moving with the emotions. And relationship, marriage and commitment is there. So enjoy, guys. If you like our channel, kindly like, share and subscribe. Let's check the energies for Scorpions this week. How this week is to be, how you need to focus, in which field you need to focus. The first card for you is Wisdom. Act with wisdom and people will respect you. There may be some situation that you need to show what you are and how you are. At that time, you have to be with wisdom and dignity so that people around you can make out that what kind of person you are. Let's see what the higher dimensional cards and higher dimensional people want to give you that. Advice. The first card is Dolphin. It suggests that live lightly and wisely, serve with wisdom and joy. Again, this card says that you need to bring out your wisdom, all these days which you have accumulated in yourself. That will bring out what kind of person you are and how you are going to make choices in life. The second card for you is Positivity. This card says success awaits you. Eliminate everything negative, gossip, doubt, fear, everything you eliminate and only attract positivity in life. That will bring, when you put positivity, you will get positivity. That's what this card says. The third card for you is Crystal Skulls. This card says a mystery is waiting to unfold. Some great thing is going to happen in your life. Perhaps new information is going to come in your life about some old thing in your life, and also it will make you take a important decision in life. Some major thing is going to happen, some new thing is going to be revealed, by which you may be annoyed and take new decision. But at that time, be positive and take the decision with wisdom. That's what this card says from the higher dimensions. Let's see what the tarot card has to say for you. What is in store for you? What are the messages from the tarot card? the first card for you is Five of Pentacles. At this situation, the Five of Pentacles says that you will be left alone, you will feel alone, that all other people are in one side, you are left one side. But at that time, don't feel lonely. Think that the Almighty is always with you and take decisions with wisdom. The second card for you is Queen of Pentacles, but the Queen of Pentacles says some woman in your life or the higher realms will send some person in your life who will care you, nourish you, and who will give solace to you. That's what this card says. Then the third card for you is Magician. Again, here the card has come positivity. What you put, you can manifest it. Here also the card, manifestation card of Magician has come. So be positive. You, what you manifest, that you will get. If you put good, you will get good. You put bad, you will get bad. So be very careful at this junction, that you, what you put, you will get it back. So put good things to attract good things. So let's see what the angels have to say to you. The first card, sir, is assertiveness. This situation can be healed gently with love as you are requested. We will stand right behind as you speak truth, giving you strength and guiding your words. So this card says that this time you need to be assertive, what is good to you, and be channelized in positive things so that the angels stand by you and give you support at this time. The second card for you, this heart chakra. Love is the heart of the matter. Your heart is the center of physical being, attuned as we stand by with perfect protection and guidance. So all these cards, what I can tell you is some major shuffle in your emotions is there. This card says, and this card says, and both cards say, all are telling that there is some emotional shift in your mind. But the angels in the higher realms will give you and nourish you at this time with their support. So be bold, guys. If you like our channel, like, share and subscribe. Check the energies for Sagittarians this week, how you need to focus. Flight is the card. Let your creative imagination fly. This card says that your creative imagination, at last the time has come where your imaginations can fly and become a reality. So you need to carefully pick up your thoughts, what you want to manifest, and imagine that happening, and it can happen. The higher realms are sending you. The first card for you is blessings. Blessings are there on you today. Remember, all you give out returns to you multiplied. So again, the card, same card comes here. Imagination. You put good imagination, you get the imagined things happening in your life multifold. You think one, you get 10. So think wisely and take decisions, because the blessings of the universe are with you this week. And the other card is healing. If you are not able to do that, it is best that you go for some spiritual healing for you to cleanse and detoxify yourself to manifest good things in your life. And the third card for you is High Priestess. This card says access your wisdom and listen to your intuition. Your intuition plays a very important role. That is, rather than thinking about the present and brooding, think about the your life, that it can be rectified by the universe. But you need to act by your intuition rather than the external fears you have. Let's see what the tarot has to say. Three of Wands says that you are in a comfortable situation now. Everything is going well. You need to be with patience and things will unfold on its own. You need not do anything. Just have faith in the universe and go along. The second card is King of Wands, that you can manifest good things. You have the capacity to do it and you can do that. That's this card says. Third card for you is Temperance. At this time, you need to be with the balance. That is what, rather than giving place and space for fears and anxieties, you need to be at balance and let the universe work for you. That's what the Three of Wands also say. Let's see what the angels want to tell you. Notice the signs. Angels send you little signs that you have to accumulate and bring hope in your life. That's what the angel says. They send you sometimes feathers, some synchronicity of thinking, of synchronicity of opinions with your family members, or repeatedly seeing some numbers will give you the positive attitude that the angels are with you. So notice those signs and bring hope in your life. The other card is focus on service, and this card says put your entire focus upon staying in the stream of giving and receiving every situation and in all that you do, whatever you do, the work you do, what you receive, focus on it and do only good things so that what you do, you get it back. So do good to get it back. So that is the message from the angels this week. If you like our channel, kindly like, share and subscribe. Let's check the energies for Capricorns this week. In which matter you need to focus? The card is intuition. Listen to your inner wisdom. Your intuition is going to work a major role this week. So pay attention to your intuitions. That's what the card says. Let's see what the higher realms have to say. The card is cooperation. The card says cooperation is a vision greater than yourself. It may be your friend or your time, something more away, anything you no longer need. So you need to leave what no longer serves you and be cooperative with the angels and the higher realms. What messages they are giving, you have to go by the flow rather than resisting it. That's what this card says. The second card for us is education. This card says that this card you have got because you need to learn yourself new things in your life and spread that knowledge. Universe will send you new things, new ideas, new messages that you need to understand, and you need to spread it to others, so your knowledge. So that is the card you have got. So angels and higher realm people are going to give you messages that you have to understand and spread it. The other card is materialization. This card says that focus your vision and make it happen. So this card says listen to your intuition. This card says we will send signals. So this card says that you can materialize new things in your life, so that focus on good things so that you can materialize good things. Let's see what the tarot card has to say. The card, first card for you is Three of Swords, says that there is some setback in your life, maybe love life or your understanding with others, but you need to be with more maturity and trust your wisdom rather than the situation. The second card for you is Seven of Pentacles. This card says that even though the situation may appear not to be good, but what hard work you have done in your relationship or in your career or in whichever sphere of your life you are feeling some setback, that is going to come to fruition this time. So you need to be patient rather than losing your hope. The third card for you is Knight of Cups. So this is a very good card coming. If it is in relationship, you will get someone with good news who will help you or reconcile with you, or if it is career, you will get a new job, new opportunity coming in your life. So life is better. So don't brood upon what has happened in the recent, or don't brood upon the negative aspects in your life. The angel card for you is ask. Ask us to help and you in this situation, and we will immediately go to work on your behalf. So it is said in the scriptures, ask, it will be given, knock, it will be opened. So this, the card says the same thing. You ask the universe, you ask the angels, you ask the Almighty to help you, and the help will be given to you immediately. It is only up to you to ask and it will be given. The second card is reward yourself. You have been giving a lot of yourself lately, and it is time for you to receive. So the higher realms are sending their energies that you have been working hard. This card also says that you, what you have put, now it is time that you reap it, but you need to be patient. This card also says the same thing, that what you have put, you will get. You have been putting quite a lot of time from now, from the, in the past, but now the time is that you will reap the reward. So be hopeful, guys, and enjoy. If you like our channel, kindly like, share and subscribe. Let's check the energies for Aquarians this week. How this week is going to be, in which matter you need to focus. The card for you is help. The help you need is on its way, so keep watching for it. You have been asking the universe or someone in your life for help. That help is now in the corner for you. You are going to get it, and you are going to overcome all the situations in which you need to you need the help. That help is going to come to you. Let's see what the higher realm cards is there for you. The Sphinx. The Sphinx, your guidance is to maintain silence until it is appropriate. Keep your own counsel and secrets of others. So this card says that you need to keep your secrets, your achievements and your goals until you achieve it into yourself, because sometimes in the universe what happens, self-jealous or say others jealous work upon us with high magnitude. So this is the period like that. So whatever achievements you want to achieve or you are going through the goal attainment, keep it to yourself until you attain it. So that is the advice from the higher realms. The other card is mind control. This card says concentrate your power of your mind for good. Watch your thoughts carefully. So again this card says at this time of junction when help is going to come, when you are going to achieve your goals, concentrate on your mind and control negative thoughts, because negative thoughts will attract negative things and will not help you in manifesting things. That's the thing. When clairvoyance, the other card, it is time, trust your inner vision and knowing. It is time to develop your intuition. So here it says that rather than thinking anxiety, panic about the situation, think with higher perspective and intuition that things are going to happen for your highest good and things are happening in your way. So become little bit stimulate your clairvoyant quality. What the tarot cards has to say now. First card for you is the Hierophant. The thing is that you are a learned person, or you you take the blessings or advice from a learned person in and around you. When you have confusions in life, that will solve many of your problems. Or you put your intuition in the forefront so that you can take better decisions in life. That's the card for you there. The second card is again Hermit. The card says, again it says, it reassures that things are happening in your way, but you need to put your wisdom here. You take better decisions with your wisdom, then only you can manifest. So second card again says that if you have the inner wisdom, if you have the intuition, put it. If you don't have, you take it from others who can help you. That's the card from the Hierophant has to say. The third card for you is Death card. The Death card says a big major shuffle in energy is going to happen. Something very, say, some thing which was there from quite a time is going to end and a new era is going to start. So be prepared for it. That's what the card says. So at that time you need to have your inner strength and intuition to put what you need to put and invite good things and get the timely help from the higher realms. Let's see what the angels have to say. The angel says, be honest with yourself. Don't go that what others see, what others want. Be honest. Really ask the higher realms what you really want. And be honest with yourself. Don't cheat yourself by suppressing your wishes or your ambitions and sacrificing. Rather, be honest to yourself to bring good things in your life and manifest good things. And other card is ground yourself. At this time, your mind, body and soul will be so overwhelmed with panic or fear, or sometimes due to enthusiasm as things are manifesting or things are changing. There will be a higher change in your vibration of your mind. At that time you need to ground yourself. Spend some time in walking barefoot. That will help you to ground yourself. So be in balance to invite good things in life. So if you like our channel, kindly like, share and subscribe. Let's check the energies for Pisces this week. How you need to focus your energy this week. The first card for is soul satisfaction. Aim for that which makes your soul rejoice. The most important thing in one's life is your soul satisfaction. Never do any work which your soul rejects. Do whether it is a big thing or a small thing, do it what your soul wants you to do. Never do what your soul doesn't want you to do. Let's see what the higher realm card says for you. The first card for is recording crystals. This card says, open your mind to new information. Human mind is a recording of incidents happening in your life. So open your mind for new informations in your life so that it be stored in your mind, so that at times when you need it, you get it back. The second card is the seven pillars of wisdom. This card says, change your life by following the spiritual laws. Here, thought, words and action has to be taken care, and watch your thoughts and concentrate on wholesome ones to create the life you want. So now you should think what really you want, what really you don't want. Make the choice and put that in action. That will bring soul satisfaction to you. And also the seven pillars of the wisdom, what the spiritual law says, that also you need to follow so that you can be true to your soul. The third card is love of animals. You need to learn that animals and learn about the animals' welfare, how they feel. They also have feelings. They also, it is from the universal God that he has created a man and animals both. We need to respect each other. So if animals can't respect the human because of their unknowingness, but most of the time animals are friendly with a man unless and until man is going to go and give them harm. But man is otherwise. Even they are not going to harm you, he goes and harms them. That is not correct. You need to balance the universe with the love towards animals. That's what the card says. Now let's see what the tarot cards has to say. Love the animals also says that in some scriptures they say human mind is like animal. So taming it is also a good idea here. So the first card for you is the Empress. The card says that success is there for you. Good relations manifesting and childbirth is indicated for you. Second card for you is Six of Wands, says victory is there for you, success is there for you, things manifesting according to your wish is there. And third card for you is Nine of Swords. It says, but in spite of getting such good cards, good things are in progress for you. You will have some backlogs or something pulling you back that makes you feel annoyed, anxiety, panic, restless and all that you need to overcome. Let's see what the angels have to say. The card for you is fresh air. Your body needs refreshment and oxygenated air. So find some time in fresh air in nature so that that's good for you. Find yourself some time to spend in nature, that will help you. The other card is energy work. If that is not possible, some energy work doing is good for you. If you know Reiki, meditation, do that. If you don't have that, put some beautiful peace music and listen to it, or you ask the help of some healer to heal you with their energy so that you can overcome all toxin fears in your life and put in positive way to create good things in life. So if you like our channel, like, share and subscribe.